If you've ever tried setting up Kubernetes, you know how frustrating it can be. But what if I told you there's a way to do it in just a few clicks? With Rancher and DigitalOcean, you can deploy a Kubernetes cluster without any headaches. In this video, I'll guide you through the exact steps to get your cluster up and running. Let's get started. Here's our plan. First, we'll connect Rancher with DigitalOcean. Then we'll create a Kubernetes cluster in just a few clicks. And finally, we will deploy a test app to make sure everything is running smoothly. Before we can create a Kubernetes cluster in Rancher, we first need to create an API token from DigitalOcean. To generate a token, log into your DigitalOcean console, go to API, and click Generate New Token. Give it a meaningful name and make sure you enable full access. This is important so Rancher can create and manage clusters on your behalf. Once the token is generated, copy it and store it safely. You won't be able to see it again. Now let's move to Rancher and use this token to create our Kubernetes cluster. In Rancher, go to Cluster Management, select Cloud Credentials, and click Create. Use DigitalOcean, give the credential a meaningful name, and paste the API token we generated earlier. And finally, click Create. Next, let's create our cluster. Go to the clusters page, click create, and select DigitalOcean. For this demo, I'll create one master node that contains control plane and etcd, and one worker node. Now, let's configure our cluster. To assign different node roles, we need to create two separate node pools, one for the master node and another for the worker node. Each node pool comes with several key settings, name, which is a label for identifying the pool, count, the number of nodes in this pool, role, which defines whether the node is etcd, control plane, or worker, region and size, which determines where and how powerful the nodes will be, and finally, OS image, the operating system for the nodes. Let's start by creating a first pool for the master node. We'll name it master, set the count to 1, and assign two of the three roles, that is etcd and control plane. For the OS, we'll select Ubuntu 24 LTS. Next, we'll add a second pool for the worker node. We'll name it worker, set the count to 1, and assign it only the worker role. Again, we'll use Ubuntu 24 LTS as the OS. There are several advanced configuration options available here, including but not limited to network settings, tags, and labels. But for this demo, we'll keep everything at default. If you would like a more detailed walkthrough of this page and all of its settings, let me know in the comments. I can cover it in a future video. Now that our cluster is up and running, let's deploy a simple Hello World application. Once you're inside cluster, go to Workloads, click Create, and select Deployment. Enter the deployment name as Hello World. For the container image, we will use Rancher/Hello World. This is a pre-built image designed for quick testing, and it runs a basic web page to confirm everything is working. Next, we need to expose our deployment. We'll set the service port to 80 and choose the cluster IP as the service type. This means the application will be accessible within the cluster only. However, Rancher automatically sets up an internal proxy, allowing us to view the web page from the internet through the Rancher UI. Once everything is set, click Create to create the deployment. Now that our deployment is running, let's verify it. Go to Services, find Hello World, and click on the HTTP link. This opens Rancho's built-in proxy page, where we should see our Hello World app running. And that's how you set up a Kubernetes cluster in DigitalOcean using Rancho. We connected Rancho, created a cluster, and deployed a test workload, all in just a few steps. But what if you already have a Kubernetes cluster running somewhere else? In the next video, I'll show you how to import an existing cluster into Rancho and manage it effortlessly. So make sure you subscribe and stay tuned.